Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today I'm going to open and review a UV-S9 Plus Baofeng ham radio, amateur radio. Thought you'd be interested in seeing it. I've been doing some videos on disaster and alternative communications. This is one I think you'll be interested in seeing. Here we are, brand new box, just got it in from Amazon last night. I'll leave a link in the description below. Let's open it up and see what we have. By the way, this is an 8-watt radio, and that's part of the reason that I purchased this particular radio. UV-S9 Plus. volt. Says it is a Baofeng. Has a 2200 milliamp battery with it. Let's see if it's charged enough to turn on.
Channel mode.
Well, there we go, channel mode. So it is charged enough to turn on. Obviously it comes with the typical things, you know, the earbuds. I'm going to set those aside. A user manual. I got it from ABBREE. ABBREE is a very reputable company. One of the things that was attractive about this particular radio is it has a charging port on the side of the battery, and it comes with a USB cable to charge it. So you don't have to use the charging cradle, although you do get a charging cradle. You get the wall wart, as we call them. You get the charging cable. You get the hand strap, the belt clip, the typical rubber ducky antenna, and another thing that was attractive to me was this. Let's see if we can get it out easily. Here we go. It came with a quarter wave antenna, a ABBREE AR-771, so it's a Nagoya NA-771 knockoff. SMA female on the radio, and so you have, SMA male on the radio, so you have an SMA female on the antenna. Seems to be going on okay. All right, let's turn this thing on.
Channel mode.
See what kind of reception we might get. Has a call button. Has a monitor button down here, which probably if you push it. There we go. The alarm works. Push to talk works. It has a A and B selector here, so it's a dual band radio, so you can get 2 meters and 70 centimeters on this. There's the
I suppose.
There's the FM. The monitor button at the bottom turns the light on, makes it flash, turns it off. The one at the top, you hold it and it puts it in alarm, but you press it one time quickly and it puts it on FM, and then you press it again, it comes off. Let's look. Here's the menu button.
Menu.
Press the menu. There's Squelch. It's all on 3. I highly recommend that you reprogram this with Chirp. And in doing so, you can change your Squelch settings and literally make them work. Because now the way they are out of the box, the Squelch doesn't work when you change it here on the keypad. But let me press menu here and move to transmit power, and it's on high right now. And so, let's leave it there. And then hit exit. And let me get out my meter, and let's see how many watts this thing actually has. Set these aside. Let's do a little test here. Get my Surecom out. Okay, I have my Surecom antenna analyzer, and it is also a power meter. So, get this thing out. I keep it wrapped up just as though it's new all the time. That way, every component piece is in there, and I'm not losing any of it. I'm looking for my pocket knife because I need to pry a little piece out right there. A little connector. Alright. Get my dummy load out. Get my connector here. You have to take your antenna off. So I'll turn off the radio. Put on the little adapter. I found if you don't put on this little gold adapter, when you connect to this to the radio, it won't give you a correct reading. And so I suggest you use this little adapter that comes with it. Okay. You put on the dummy load here. Just turn the radio back on.
Channel mode.
There we go. Turn on the SWR meter, which is also the power meter. Hold that. Put it on FW, which is transmitting power. Press the button. Push the talk button. 5.5, 5.6, 5.4 watts. And it's on high. Mid. Let me try that one. Menu. Exit. And let's try that. 4.6, and low is like 0.91. So basically 1 watt, about 4.5 watts, and about 5.5 watts is what we're getting here.
Menu.
Now that's on the 440, not on 2 meter. So let me change that to 2 meter, and let's see what it'll do on high power. 6.3. So usually it'll do a little bit better on 2 meter than it will on 70 centimeter, oddly enough. Let me try this as well. Let me put the antenna on there instead of this dummy load and see what it'll do. And you say, well, it should do the same thing. It doesn't always do the same thing. And you see that 6.3 right there that we got on the last transmission with the dummy load. Okay, put on the antenna and let's see what it'll do. .3, 5.4, 5.6, 5.5. So take my hand off of it. This does affect transmission, excuse me. 5.8, 5.7, 5.9. There you go. So just short of 6 watts. But that's not bad for a radio that, you know, claims to be 8 watts. It's really not. The question is whether it transmits good and clear. And I'll find a local repeater here. I'll find the local repeater frequency and turn this thing off. And we'll try that. Gotta get a pair of pliers. We'll try a local repeater frequency. I need to get into repeater book here quickly with my phone and find the Jonesboro repeater. Let me see. I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back again. I had to pause for a moment, get out my programming cable, and actually program this with chirp, because repeaters have offsets and they require you to program a little bit more than you can typically do with, you can actually do it with the keypad, but it would take you forever. So I took a few minutes and I programmed this. And by the way, I found out that this particular UV-S9 Plus is a tri-band radio, and I didn't know that whenever I purchased it. But whenever I looked inside the manual, and it's important to read the manuals, I found out that it gave me some things in the 220 frequencies. And so that's a plus. Let me turn it on here. I've got it on a local Jonesboro repeater. Let's see if I can reach it. KI5 UEI repeater check. There we go. So I can reach my local repeater with this antenna. I have a signal stick coming, and I'm interested in seeing how well it does. This one is 15 inches basically. 14.9 to 15.1. The signal stick is 19, and as I understand it, it's a better wavelength variant than this particular antenna, and so we'll see. But this radio I bought to actually keep out and use, as opposed to storing away the other ones for emergencies. And I have them at my home and in vehicles and whatever, in case we get stranded or we have a natural disaster, communication is out, I have those radios ready and available for that. This one is going to be the radio that I'm going to use in the home, use around, carry it with me, whatever. And so I wanted one that was high power. It's a plus that it's a tri-band, and I wanted one with a better antenna. And so plus, I got a little better battery, and I got the ability to charge it from the side here. So, not bad for just a little over $30. Got it from ABBREE. I'll leave the link below. A plus is that it came with this antenna, and if this antenna is as good as Nagoya, they cost $21 on Amazon. So that's a plus. I think I made a good purchase. What do you think? Leave me a comment below. If you have any questions, leave a question below. Hey, thank you for taking time to be on our channel. See you on the next video. God bless you.